students, I welcome again to the online class. Now we have revised the lesson how plants reproduce. Do you remember, children? Reproduction means the process by which new individual organisms, for example, new plants are produced from their parent plants. Plants reproduce in many ways. Most plants reproduce through seeds. New plants can be grown using a very small piece of the mother plant in controlled conditions for growth in a laboratory. This special technique is called tissue culture. We know that seeds are present inside the fruits. Most plants have reproduced by their seeds. When the seed gets the right amount of air, water, and warmth, it starts growing into a small plant called the seedling. This process is called germination. The process of seeds developing into a new plant is called germination. A seed starts growing into a baby plant called the seedling. What are the things needed to grow a new plant? Air, water, and warmth. How the seeds will be grow? The seed takes up water, activating enzymes that begin the growth process. Water enters the seed through the hole present in the seed coat. Seed coat means outer covering of the seed. Then the seed coat breaks open and the root of the baby plant emerges. The embryo will be swelled and lengthened. Embryo means a small baby plant inside a seed. The root of the baby plant starts growing. The plant grows in size and new leaves start developing. The new plant keeps growing as long as it gets air, water, light, and fertile soil. These are the stages of germination of seeds. Next topic is dispersal of seeds. Plants need to scatter their seeds far away from them to ensure that seeds grow into a new plants. This process is called dispersal of seed. What is dispersal? The process by which seeds are scattered far away from the mother plant is called dispersal. How the plants spread their seeds by wind? Many plants have seeds that are very light. It is easy to carry away by wind. These seeds have hair or wing-like structures. It helps them to be easily carried away by the wind to other places. For example, cotton, dandelion, swan plants, etc. Next one is dispersal by water. Seeds of many plants growing near water bodies are dispersed by water. These seeds are spongy or fibrous coating. So, it is easy to float in water far away from the mother plant. For example, lotus, lily, and coconut plants are dispersed by water. Next one is dispersal by animals. Seeds of some plants have hooks and spines. So, these seeds stick to the bodies of birds and animals. They carried off to faraway lands. For example, cocklebur and burdock seeds stick to the bodies of birds and animals. Next method is dispersal by explosion or explosive mechanism. Some plants have a special method of scattering their seeds on their own force when the fruit ripens. Some plants like balsam, peas, beans are dispersed their seeds by explosion and scatter their seeds in all directions. What are the four methods of seed dispersal? Dispersal by wind, dispersal by water, dispersal by animals, and dispersal by explosion. Some plants reproduce with the help of their roots, stems, or leaves. This method is called vegetative propagation. Carrot, turnip, beetroot, and radish reproduce with the help of their roots. These roots are thick and fleshy. New plants are growing from their fleshy roots in the soil. Some plants like potato, onion, garlic, and ginger reproduce with the help of their stems. Onion and garlic can grow from bulb. Potato and ginger have small buds that grow on their surface. Each bud can grow into a new plant. Plants like hibiscus, rose, money plant can grow into a new plants with the help of stem cuttings of the mother plant. Some plants like bryophyllum have special leaves that develop buds on the leaf margins. New plants start growing from the buds. What are the three methods of vegetative propagation? From roots, from stems, and from leaves.
Good morning, children. Children, do you know the plant? Yes. What are the parts they have? Root, stem, leaves, flower and fruit. Is it? Listen here. Now we are studying about reproduction of plant. Is it? Reproduction of plant. All the living things reproduce their own kind. Like that, plants also reproduce their small plant. Okay. First one is germination. Before reproduction, we need the germinate. How some plants reproducing through their seeds. Okay, most of the plants reproducing new plant, reproducing their new plant through their seeds. Listen here. First one is from the seed, how the plants will be grow. Okay, so we see that first germination. Okay, the seed will be, because of germination, seed will be grow to the new plant. Okay, first stage is, what are the things needed for germination? Air, water and sunlight. Okay, air, water and sunlight. See here, air, water and sunlight. Sunlight means warmth. Already we studied, no, warmth, air, water and sunlight. Listen here, first stage, we should keep a seed in the soil. Okay, after watering the seed, what will be grow first? This is the root of a baby plant. Okay, root of a baby plant will start to the emerges. Then after one, seed coat. Okay, what is the seed coat? Seed coat is the outer covering of the seed. Seed coat is the outer covering of the seed. Then the seed coat will be breaks. After the embryo will be start to grow. Okay, what is the meaning of embryo? Embryo means, what is that? A small baby plant. Embryo means a small baby plant. Okay, after that, the seed coat, the embryo will be grown faster. Okay, embryos will be grown faster. Next, this type of, what is this? Seed leaves. Okay, small seeds will be start to grow. This is the seed leaves. Okay, children, first stage, seed. After breaking the seed coat, embryo will be start to grow. After the seed coat, embryo will be start to grow. Then the seed leaves will be come out, and roots and stems, leaves will be started to grow. After, it will become a big plant. Okay, what are the conditions needed for germination? Air, water and sunlight. Air, water and sunlight. Next one is disposal of seeds. What is this? Dispersal of seeds. What is the meaning of dispersal of seeds? That means plants need to scatter their seeds from one place to another place. Okay, this is the dispersal of seeds. Plants scatter their seeds from one place to another place. This is called dispersal. Okay, what are the three types of dispersal? It has four types. Okay, dispersal of seeds has four types. What are they? First one is dispersal by wind. Dispersal by wind. Second one is dispersal by water. Third one is dispersal by animals. Fourth one is dispersal by explosion. What are the four types of dispersal of seeds? Dispersal by wind, dispersal by water, dispersal by animals and dispersal by explosion. First one is dispersal by wind. How the seeds will be there? The some seeds are very light. Okay, some seeds of plants are very light. It is a, what the, parachute like a structure. Okay, the seeds of a plants are parachute like a structure. It is very light, so it is very easy to carry the seeds by the wind. It will be scattered from one place to another place through the wind. Okay, next one is disperse. What are the examples of dispersal by wind? Say some plants. Cotton, swamp plant and dandelion. Okay, next one is dispersal by water. Okay, these are the seeds are very spongy. Okay, these are the seeds are through the water it will be scattered. Okay, the seeds are scattering through the water. For example, coconut, lotus and lily. Okay, these are the seeds are very spongy and fibrous coating. Spongy and fibrous coating. Third one is dispersal by animals. Some seeds, some plants of seeds are, how it will be there? It will be have hooks. Okay, hooks and spines. It will be like this. These are the hooks and spines. The seeds are hooks and spines. These types of seeds will be stick to the bodies of animals or birds. Okay, these are the seeds stick to their bodies of animals and birds. Like that, these are the seeds will be spread to from one place to another place. What are the examples of that? Cock liver, burdock. Okay, fourth method is dispersal by explosion. Do you know, children? Dispersal by explosion. Some plants like peas, beans, these are the plants, after ripen these fruits, it will be blast. Okay, after drying these fruits or ripen the fruits, it will be blast. After blasting the seeds will be spread from one place to another place. Like that, this will be dispersal by explosion. Seeds will be spread from one place to another place. What are the examples of dispersal by explosion? Peas, balsam, poppy. Okay, these are the examples of dispersal by explosion. Okay, dispersal by wind, dispersal by water, dispersal by animals and dispersal by explosion. Next one is vegetative propagation. What is the next topic? Vegetative propagation. Listen here. Some plants reproduce through their seeds, but some plants reproduce from their roots, stems or leaves. Okay, roots, stems or leaves. First one is from roots. Can you say some examples of plants reproduce from their roots? Yes, carrot, turnip, carrot, turnip, and radish, etc. Okay, these are the roots are very fleshy. Okay, strengthened and very fleshy because of that roots will be grow to the new plant. Okay, this is the type of vegetative propagation. Some plants growing through the root. Okay, for example, this is the carrot. Soil. Okay, this root of the carrot will be very fleshy and strengthened. Because of that, this is the new plant. Okay, from here the new plant will be grow. Next one is from stem. What are the plants growing from the stem? Potato, ginger, onion, garlic, etc. Okay, listen, these are the stems. These are the plants of stems will be grow to a new plant. From the potato and ginger, they have buds. Okay, from there they have buds. From these buds, new plants will be grow. Okay, from the potato and ginger, new plants will be grow from the buds. And onion and garlic have bulb. What is the pot? Bulb. From the bulb, new plants will be grow. Next one is stem cuttings. See, in our home we will use some plants to cutting the stems. Which are the plants we will use? That rose, is it? Will you use the rose? When we cutting the stems, we have to grow the new plant, is it? So that is stem cuttings. Next one is from leaves. See, some plants like bryophyllum. Do you know the plant of bryophyllum? Yes. See, from that bryophyllum, it has a special pot. Okay, what is that? It has a special pot. It will be called buds. For example, leaf will be like this. From this area, small plants will be grown. Okay, this is the bryophyllum leaves. Bryophyllum leaves growing from their leaves of buds. Okay, through this buds the new plants will be grow. Okay, what are the vegetative propagation? Three types of vegetative propagation: from root, from stem and from leaves. Did you understand the lesson, children? Okay, today I will send the notes to you. You have to learn the question answers. Okay children, thank you.